Now let us derive an equation for, or a mathematical relation for, the Euler's equation of motion. So we have a fluid element of length ds, in which you are having a flow in the direction s. So this is the flow direction, this is how the flow is occurring. So, or you can say, on this flow, which is represented by this line s, we are assuming a fluid element of length l, or ds. Now, the area of this fluid element, or the cross section area, is dA. So let us say, in the direction of flow, the pressure force acting is PdA, and on the other end there will be an opposite pressure force, which is P plus the variation of P with the length into the total length, and you will have dA, because the pressure varies with the depth. Now, that is what you have on there. So you have your weight of the element acting vertically downwards, and the angle between the direction of flow and the weight is theta. So let us say that the density of this fluid is rho. So this would be rho into g, that's the specific weight, into the volume would be dA into ds. Alright. So the motion is happening in that direction, and you have some forces in the downward direction, okay, and some forces in the upper direction, means you need to have a net force which will produce this motion. So you will have PdA, that's the force in the upward direction, minus that force, P plus curly P by curly S into ds dA, and the cos component of this along the direction of flow. So it will be minus rho g dA ds cos theta. So this is a net force. Net force is going to produce, this is equal to net force, which produces the motion with an acceleration. So the mass would be density into volume into the acceleration in the direction of s. So that is A parenthesis s. Okay, so if you say that the velocity of the flow is v, so v would be a function of s and t, so it would be a function of space and time. So I have to find out as. As would be the differential of v with respect to t, but v is further a function of s and t. So I'll have to use the partial differential. So I'll use curly v upon curly s into ds by dt plus curly v upon curly t. Now ds upon dt is velocity again. So you will write it down as v into curly v upon curly s. And let us assume that the flow which is happening is steady flow. So the time variation of the velocity will become 0. So you will be only left with this. So this is 0 because of steady flow conditions. So As is equal to v into curly v by curly s. So when you open the brackets, you can strike off this and p over here, and you will be left with minus curly p upon curly s into ds dA minus rho g dA ds cos theta is equal to rho into dA ds into v into curly v upon curly s. Okay. Now let's divide the entire equation by rho dA ds. So divide it. So you will get minus curly p upon curly s ds dA upon rho ds dA minus rho g dA ds upon rho ds dA, and this has cos theta as well, and this will be equal to, this will get cancelled, and you will have curly v, or let us first of all write v. So v into curly v upon curly s. Okay, so this and this can get cancelled off, this entire thing will go off. So you'll have minus, or let's say 1 by rho negative curly P by curly S minus G cos theta is equal to V curly V by curly S. Now if you look at that triangle over there, so you will have, yeah, the entire thing is gone now. You just have G cos theta. So this is the value. So you will have ds upon dz, or dz upon ds would be cos theta. So if you want to find out cos theta, it will be dz upon ds. So let's put that value over here. So we will get, take the negative sign onto that side, bring that term over here, you will get all positive signs. So it will be 1 by rho curly P upon curly S plus G into cos theta is dz upon ds plus V into curly V by curly S equal to 0. Now from the bottom we have ds, ds and ds. You can take ds common. So you will have 1 by ds into 1 by rho into curly P plus G into dz plus V into dv. Now ds, 1 by ds cannot be 0. So the only thing that can be 0 is this part. So I'll write down 1 by rho, or simply dp by rho plus g into dz plus v into dv equal to 0. So this equation that you see on your board over here, this is called the Euler's equation of motion. This is the Euler's equation of motion. So I hope you understood this mathematical derivation of the Euler's equation. Now let's move on to the next video and look at how to derive the Bernoulli's equation with the help of the Euler's equation.